The project is a real-time chat application that allows multiple users to join a chat room and send messages to each other in real time. The application is built using the ReactJS framework on the front end and Node.js with Express.js and Socket.io on the back end. When a user opens the application, they are prompted to enter a username and a room ID. Once they have entered this information and clicked the Join a Room button, the application uses Socket.io to connect to the server and join the specified chat room. Once a user has joined a room, they can see all the messages that have been sent in that room and send their own messages by typing them into the input box at the bottom of the screen, clicking the Send button. When a user sends a message, it is broadcast to all the other users in the same room in real time. The application also features some basic styling and UX design to make it more user-friendly, including a chat window with a header, body, and footer, and a scrolling feature that automatically scrolls to the bottom of the chat window as new messages are received. Now let's discuss code in detail. The code consists of two parts: a back-end implementation using Node.js and the Express framework, and a front-end implementation using React.js. Back-end implementation. The back-end code is written in Node.js and Express, which is a web application framework for Node.js. It creates a server using HTTP and Socket.io, and listens for connections from clients. It handles events such as when a user joins a chat room or sends a message, and broadcasts messages to all clients in the same room using Socket.io. This allows multiple users to participate in a real-time chat session. Front-end implementation. The front-end code is written in React, which is a JavaScript library for building user interfaces. It sets up a chat window where users can enter their username and room ID to join a chat. The chat component handles sending and receiving messages using Socket.io and updates the message list in real time. Thanks for watching. If you want to see the code used in this tutorial, please visit my website at codingcirculate.com. And if you found this video helpful, please hit the subscribe button and turn on notifications so you don't miss any future videos.